Hello, my name is Zach Coley and I'm a research associate here at the lab. Part of my job includes working with this device behind me, which is called the sweeper magnet. If the magnet looks really big, that's because it is. It's a superconducting dipole magnet with a maximum field of 4 tesla and weighs about 50,000 pounds. Its job is literally to sweep the charged particles aside that are left over from a nuclear reaction that takes place right in front of it. That's why we refer to it as the sweeper magnet. A beam of radioactive isotopes produced at the NSCL comes in through the wall right over here. This beam hits a target where very neutron-rich nuclei that researchers are interested in studying can be produced. However, these very neutron-rich nuclei immediately break up or decay into a charged nuclear fragment and one or more neutrons. Now, the neutrons have no charge or are neutral, so they aren't affected by the magnetic field of the sweeper magnet and continue flying straight into the neutron detector, Mona Lisa. But the charged fragment that's left over feels the magnetic field and gets bent away into a new direction. In the space of about 1 meter, the charged particle gets deflected up to 43 degrees, even though it's flying at more than 55 million miles per hour. Behind the sweeper magnet is a variety of detectors which we can use to measure the charge, mass, angle, and energy of the fragment after it's swept away by the magnet. By combining this information with the corresponding information from the neutrons, it's possible to reconstruct and learn about the properties of that original very neutron-rich exotic nucleus, even though it exists for only a very short amount of time.